Mumbai police has arrested a 21-year-old boy in connection with the alleged auction of Muslim women on the app called Bullybuy. According to the DCP of Mumbai Police Cybercell, the 21-year-old engineering student has been questioned for the last 10 hours. He was detained from Bengaluru yesterday. In fact, the Mumbai police have also so far recorded the statements of two victims, and they've also detained another suspect in this case. The Mumbai police shared the details of the accused with the Bengaluru police only after detention. In fact, in its recent statement, the online platform GitHub has responded, saying that they have already suspended the account of the user as it has a long-standing policy against content and conduct involving harassment, discrimination, and inciting violence. In fact, the online platform also added that the Delhi police should come through proper legal channels. The Delhi police had earlier sought details from GitHub platform, which hosted the Bullybuy app.
It happened on Twitter. Actually, it happened last 6 months back when Sulli Deals occurred. I was one of my clients from Bombay. And then we had registered a complaint and to cyber itself. The investigation team was working on it from last 6 months. Though the FIR was not taken, but certainly they're working it since the FIR was taken in Delhi. And this thing happened 2 days back, and I got a message from a friend that this again has happened. And then I tweeted on Twitter that people who want to register their complaint, we will file their complaints. So many victims came towards me and they approached me. So one of the victims I'm representing from Bombay, there are two from Hyderabad, there are two from Delhi, one from Kerala, and there is a Kashmiri journalist from Srinagar. So basically the FIR has been taken place in Bombay and Delhi. Today it might take in Hyderabad also, because one of the victims is a 69-year-old social activist who has been there on grounds for people during the COVID time, and I cannot expect someone like her demeanor to be there in their list. So that shows about their mentality, that how these people have gone down to outrage Muslim women protesting. And since they were not caught the last time, I hope they are being caught now, because Mumbai police has taken stringent action against them and they are witch hunting us, and I definitely know that we will catch them. I believe in Mumbai police, okay, because DCP itself is involved in this case.
My colleague Sandeep now joins me live on the broadcast. Now, Sandeep, while we are talking about a twin probe in both Delhi and Mumbai, we also know about a second person who has been detained by the Mumbai police. Do we have the details here?
See, as of now, there is, no much information given by the Mumbai police. But what our sources are telling us is that a lady has been detained from Uttarakhand. That's what our sources say. And as of now, there is no confirmation, rather, in regards of this. But yes, this is what we are hearing from our sources in Mumbai police. So definitely a major breakthrough after one arrest and second detainee. Detention of a lady is a big breakthrough. And Mumbai police is, indeed digging out all the aspect of this bully by app, like how it was operated, who was the person behind the app, what was the modus operandi, what was the agenda behind this app, and why there was instant effort made by this app to target Muslim women's. So definitely this is a major breakthrough for Mumbai police, and the investigation is still underway. The first accused has been arrested and he will be produced in the courthouse in some time. So the second person has been detained from Uttarakhand, and he will be brought to Mumbai soon. So definitely Mumbai police is connecting the keys, connecting the puzzles, and trying to solve the mystery of the Bullybuy app.
Right, Sandeep, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast with all those inputs. We'll keep coming back to you for more. Meanwhile, I'm also joined by Khalida Parveen. In fact, she is an activist and she's also a Bullybuy victim. I have Ms. Parveen on the broadcast live with me. Ms. Parveen, you are also one of the complainants in the case, and you have put forth certain points in that complaint copy that we have with us on Mirror Now. Just take us through that.
हेलो
यस
हेलो, हाँ, आई एम
मिस परवीन,
खालिदा
इफ यू
परवीन
कैन हियर
फ्रॉम,
मी. यस मिस परवीन, प्लीज गो
या आई
अहेड.
एम खालिदा परवीन फ्रॉम हैदराबाद, सोशल एक्टिविस्ट वर्किंग सिंस डिकेड्स इन हैदराबाद इन डिफरेंट एरियाज, स्पेशली एम्पावरिंग वुमेन. सो आई एम एक्टिव इन ट्विटर आल्सो. सो आई वाज आल्सो टारगेटेड बाय बुली बाय App. And yesterday, therefore, yesterday I came to know. Yesterday I filed a case here in Hyderabad CCS cyber crime, and they have given a good response. And I am happy to know that the one more lady is detained in Uttarakhand. So let us wait for the justice also.
Right. Also, Ms. Parveen, you are one of the victims also in this case, considering your name also has been put up on auction on this particular app, which has
Yes.
now been reportedly taken down. But the fact remains that, you know, these people are actually going ahead. And this is the second such case in, I think, 6 months, where we had a Sully Deals, which was there in July. Nothing really was done about it. And now we have this Bully app where we have Muslim women who are very active in the social sphere, their names being put up and auctioned. Your word here, sir, ma'am.
Because, you see, they want to silence us. We are vocal in the social media. Because of the social
yeah.
media, only the Shaheen Bagh was extended to the country. They know the Muslim women are very vocal now, and they can do. If they come out of the house, they will not go before success. So they want to silence us. They want to keep us quiet. They are defaming and fearing and shaming us. So we are not ashamed at all. We are not afraid at all. We will come again and again, more double their voice. We'll make our voice double and loud. And we'll ask for justice for every woman, not only for Muslim women. For every injustice, we will raise voice. Irrespective of caste, creed, even gender also. We will fight. We won't sit simply at home.
Right. Also, Ms. Parveen, you have been very vocal about, obviously, you have raised your voice against people like Narsinghananda and the entire Haridwar hate speech row. You were one of the active voices on social media. Do you think women like yourself are targeted because of they being vocal enough?
Yeah, before this, since 2 days, we were fighting for, we were in the Twitter demanding the arrest of hate speech speakers, especially in Haridwar and all. So to divert the issue, they brought this Bully Bhai app so that we will keep quiet. Because international media is also watching, international media's pressure is there in the country. So to dilute that case and divert the issue, they brought this Bully app.
Right. Also, Ms. Parveen, what does it say about a society that we are living in? Because you are, I believe, other than being an activist in the social sphere, you are a mother. A person to your stature and her name being put in an app and put there to auction. And we have people like a 21-year-old boy, a child, who has been nabbed by the police in the said case.
This is showing their rotten mentality. This is the mentality. The world is watching the mentality of the such perpetrators. So how they can use, they can behave with the woman irrespective of age. I am maybe their grandmother's age, not even mother. So to bully or to make sexual comments or make anything, insult, they can. They will go for any extent. This shows.
Right. Ma'am, we also mentioned about the Sully deals, which was happening in July, you know, only 6 months back, and nothing really was done at that time. Do you think because of an inaction by the center or by the police authorities
definitely,
is why we've
definitely.
Seen another similar case only 6 months after?
Definitely, if they had taken proper action at that time, these 112 members may have been saved. At least now, they should go for a fair investigation. There should not be any diversions. There should not be any scapegoats. They should not save somebody, that the real culprits. The real culprits should be behind the bar. They should not get escaped. These 21 years fellow, somebody is backing him. How dare he is to do all these things? To deserve so, yes, a special community of such a large number. There are some, he have backing. Who are backing him? Who is doing it? So that culprit should be come out.
Right. Also, one last thing, Ms. Parveen, before I let you go. As the complaint copy, what exactly are you seeking in the form of justice? You want the people who have been accused and people, other than the two people who have been, obviously nabbed in the case, you want them behind the bars. What else do you expect from the centre and the police authorities?
See, because we are a citizen of India, we will go according to our legal system. So legal system, what are the sections they can apply, they should apply. And especially this is for Muslim community, they are doing so. So there should be a special section also on them so that they can't dare to do again.
Right. Absolutely. Ms. Parveen, thank you so much for joining me live on the broadcast. That was Khalida Parveen, who has also been a bully by victim, speaking to us live on Mirror Now.